I was just taken aback. I was just like, wow, okay. You just literally just got up and came and didn't do nothing. You look like you didn't wash up. It may have really washed up, but because of how you look, you're not looking fresh and clean. Good morning, love bugs. It is Thursday morning, February 4th, I believe. And I am out and about this morning at 8:17 a.m. Would you like to know where we're going on this morning? Ready to get into it? I know I am. Let's discuss. Okay, guys, how is everybody this Thursday morning? We are on our way to my allergy doctor's appointment. I think I told you that I had this scheduled back in January, but they had overbooked me, and they needed to move the appointment. So this morning is the day of that appointment. So that's where we're on our way to. I need this appointment because my allergies have been just all over the place, which you guys know that. I don't think there's a vlog that goes by that I don't mention my allergies, hardly ever. But yes, I don't know if I need a, I don't want to do allergy shots. I've heard people talk about that. I've heard some people say it was absolutely wonderful. It worked for them. And then I had some people say it did nothing for them. So I don't know. But at any rate, I'm on my way to my appointment. And it just dawned on me that I came the wrong way. I have my doctor's appointment, doctors mixed up as far as where they are, the vicinity. I mean, I can get to the appointment this way. It's just going to, well, no, this is fine. There really is two ways that you can get to it. Again, your girl don't get out enough to know. I gotta do better. Anyway, we're on our way to the allergy appointment. It's a gloomy day. I don't know if it's supposed to rain today or if it's supposed to be cloudy all day or what. I didn't pay attention to the news like that. It is 53 degrees today, which I'm thankful for that. I don't know what the high is gonna be, but I'd take this over the 30s any day. So yeah, that's what we're on our way to. What can we chit chat about? It's a lot going on that I've read about. And it's all crazy. Like, it can never be just positive stuff. I mean, it's just a lot of crazy stuff that's going on, or at least the stuff that I'm seeing is the crazy stuff. So the young man who killed the two protesters in and I can't even think of the names right now, probably because I really didn't want to commit it to memory to talk about it, but it's in the news. Anyway, he was 18. He might have been 17 at the time that he did it. He's 18 now. He was out on a $2 million bond from fundraising money, and they tried to serve him with some type of court paper or document, and it was returned to sender because the person said he didn't live there anymore. Well, now they don't know where he's at, and so they filed a motion to have an arrest warrant issued for him and to increase his bond by $200,000 more because they don't believe he's taking it serious enough, and he's been out with a known Proud Boy members and all of that. So his attorney filed a document saying, well, we know where he's at. It's just that he's received a lot of death threats, and so he had to pretty much go into hiding. We will submit you his current address if you make it private, where it's not a part of the court records. So, you know, the prosecutors were like, that's not our decision to make. You, the judge, will decide that. But in the meantime, we're filing this emergency motion for him to be picked up. So anyway, that's what's going on. And it made me think, is he not on an ankle monitor? Do they not do ankle monitors anymore? Because it seems like to me that would have been a part of a condition of his release. Because I know people who have done far less and they have to wear an ankle monitor. So I don't know. So anyway, that's going on. Representative Green is still in the news. And it just gets worse. Before she became a representative, she had made comments about not believing that a plane actually flew, I think it was into the Pentagon, or some building, don't get me wrong. She didn't believe 9/11 really happened in some form or fashion. She also, I think we talked about this already, the QAnon, that she believes in the QAnon theories. And that she didn't believe the Sandy Hook shootings took place. And she also said that Nancy Pelosi and some others in Congress deserved to be killed because they committed treason, in her opinion. And then she's also supported some racially charged things as well. Well, the Republicans had a meeting to decide if they were going to remove her from some committees. I thought they were meeting to kick her out of Congress, but that was not the case. They had a meeting to see if she needed to be removed from some committees. Well, the Republicans met in private, and they said in private she apologized for what she had said and that she knows it was wrong. And she, you know, showed remorse, quote unquote. But the thing is, okay, this is always tricky. Hang on, guys, because, okay. I think I was supposed to get off right there. This is why I don't like coming this way, because I get so confused. Let me see. Hold on. No. Okay. I'm good. This is so tricky to me. Okay. So, she apologized to them, but she refuses to do a public apology and acknowledge that she was wrong. So the Democrats are voting today to go ahead and remove her from the committees that she's on because of her behavior that she refuses to back down. And she even tweeted, "I won't apologize and I'm not backing down." So she still got all that going on. Now the Republicans were trying to remove Senator Cheney from her committees because she voted to impeach Donald Trump. But since all this stuff happened with Marjorie Greene, I think that they've realized that they can't have it both ways, so they decided not to remove her from her committees as well. So I'm just like, it's just too much. It's a lot. It's just never ending. I don't even want to talk about it because it's just, but it's in the news, and it just seems like, you know, in life, I think we've all been guilty of shaping the truth how we want it to be. Shaping things how we want it to be versus what's right or wrong. But at some point, you know, you got to do what's right and own up to it. And if you have certain, I truly believe that if you have certain beliefs that are discriminatory towards a certain group of people, or, you know, you feel a certain way about that, you should not be in a public office. Because a public office is just that. It's, you are representing the public, and you have all kind of different types of people in the public, and you need to be a good representation of all of those individuals. Just my thought. So we are arriving at the doctor's appointment. I think I'm going to take you guys in with me. I don't know if they have any rules about recording we're gonna find out. So like I said, I'm gonna take you guys in here with me. And we have a couple more stops once we leave here. We've got to pick up our contact lenses, a prescription. We need to do an Amazon return. I got to go to Office Depot to have them print off the return label for me. Because I don't know what I selected when I did the return, but I selected something that's going to require me to print off the label and affix it to the box and then take it to the UPS store, whereas before I just would drop it off and they would scan a code. So I don't know what I did, but anyway, we've got some stops this morning before we get logged into work. So I did receive the new tripod, and this is how it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be tight, and so it's perfect. Oh, I don't want to break it. But yeah, so let's get our mask on. I need to. And get ready to go. Saw the doctor, and he's gonna make some changes to my allergy medicine. Plus, I've got to get a blood allergy test done because I've already had the skin test done, and he wants to make sure he's not missing anything. He also wants me to, I got several medications that I'm gonna have to try to kind of help with my allergies. But overall, it was a good visit. Waiting for the nurse to come back in to bring me my lab request where I need to go to get this lab work done, and then we'll be all done. So I'll be back. Okay guys, we are done at the doctor's office, and I am a little cold. It wasn't cold in the doctor's office, but it was cold when I got outside, and it's not really cold outside. It's only 52 degrees, but you know, I'm always cold. So it's kind of like, what's new, huh? All right, so now we're going to go get our lab drawn. She gave me two options of places to go, but I think one would be much easier to get into. versus the other. I just got to think about where I'm at. Yeah, I think I'm going to go back this way to get to it. So anyway, like I said, overall, a good doctor's appointment. And just trying to get my allergies under control because they have been out of control. And he's even a little baffled by it. He's even like, he doesn't know why my allergies are the way that they are. Oh, that's where Andy is. Excuse me. Okay. Andy's restaurant. When I was growing up, I used to love to get burgers and fries from there. And I was talking to someone and they told me that they get breakfast from there, which I didn't even know they sold breakfast or even knew where they were here. So the probability of me getting breakfast is probably slim to none because this is on a completely different side of town than where I live. And even it'd be out of the way for work. Like once we start going back into the office, I could probably do lunch if I was on this side of town, or even if I was in the office, I could probably take a lunch break and come in and get it. Although I probably wouldn't do that because, yeah. So yeah. So anyway, I'm learning something. Excuse me, while out at the doctor's, going to the doctor's. I need some caffeine. It's 9:45. My appointment was at 8:30. I like my doctor, my allergy doctor, because he's very attentive. He's probably one of my most attentive doctors. He's very detailed, very organized, very thorough. He always asks you, is there anything else that you want to talk about? Is there anything else that's going on that you might have going on that I haven't covered or brought up? I mean, I just love him. And I think I love him too because he's the doctor that helped diagnose my son's heart condition. Meaning they kept saying that he had allergies after all the different doctors we had went to. And he was the one that when he did his testing, he was like, I really don't think it's allergies. He said, I want to schedule him for some heart tests just to rule everything out. And that's what I mean by he's so thorough. And his PCP, I have to do a story time on that to give you guys all the details on it because it's really, truly, and I'm going to see if I can get my son to participate in the story time, although my son doesn't like to talk about it, but I'm going to do a story time on that because my son's a walking miracle in that regard. But yeah, my allergy doctor is so, so thorough. I mean, he just is. He checks every box. He doesn't leave any stone unturned, and I just really, 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 really love him as a doctor. So, yeah, I'm on my way to get this lab work done, this allergy lab work done. He told me it was going to be a blood test. And once I do that, I'm going to stop by my P.O. box since I'm already close to the area, check it, and then we're going to go to Office Depot. Then we're gonna go drop off this Amazon package. Then we're gonna pick up a prescription, and then we're heading home. Well, I might grab something to eat, and then we're gonna head home and get locked in for work. I've gotta get some caffeine, and I went to bed kind of early. I don't know what's going on with me. But anyway, I'll be back. Okay, guys. I am done getting my lab drawn. I feel like I'm going to bruise. Because of the way she stuck me, but I could be wrong. So now we are going to check our P.O. box. Yeah, we're going to check our P.O. box. And what else are we going to do? But anyway, okay. So, I have a pet peeve. And I'm gonna talk about it. And maybe I need to talk about it on another video. Because this video is going to be probably kind of long. Or vlogging one. I got to learn to use the appropriate words. But I'm in the building, waiting on the elevator, and I notice a lady waiting on the elevator with me, and she's an African American woman, and she has on her bed clothes, like from shoulders to toes. She has on her pajama set. And it wasn't like it was a brand new pajama set that she might have thought it was an actual outfit. No. She had slept and washed them several times. And she had on slippers. And in my mind, and she had on a blue jean jacket. And she had on a, like a knit hat. Really, car, you gonna just run me over? Oh, Jesus. Anyway, everything about her said, I just got out of bed. I mean, she didn't have her hair combed or anything. She just had this knit hat over it. And I'm like, did you not know? Like, was it going to be too much energy to wash up and put on some actual clothing to come to the doctor's office? And I really try not to say anything when I see stuff like that, because my friend told me a long time ago that, how do you know that's all, that's not all they have? That could be all they literally have to wear. And in my mind, I'm just like, I don't think so. It just bothers me when I see, when I'm out and I see us in our pajamas, our house slippers, our bonnet, hair bonnet that we sleep in. It's like we don't take the time to do something with ourselves when we come out in public. We look like we just got up and came. And that's a pet peeve of mine. And I just thought I'd share it. The other people may be like, what's the big deal? That's normal. But for me, I can't, like, I have some pajamas that are, that almost look like an outfit, because when I first saw them, I think I was with you all when I found them at Walmart. I originally was thinking they were an outfit, but then when I noticed where I was picking them up from, it was in the night attire area, you know, with the nightgowns and the pajamas and all that, the sleepwear area. So I knew it wasn't an outfit, even though it looked like an outfit per se, and it had pockets in the pants. But the material let me know that it was not an outfit, and it was not something that I would wear outside of the house, because it was thin. I have a hard time wearing that out just to take my garbage to the curb for the garbage man to pick up. Like, I feel like I need to put on a robe, or I need to put on some clothes to actually go outside to do that. That's how ingrained it is in me that those are sleep, it's sleepwear, it's not outfits. So anyway, yeah, I saw that while I was in the doctor, and I was just taken aback. I was just like, wow, okay. You just literally just got up and came and didn't do nothing. You look like you didn't wash up. It may have really washed up, but because of how you look, you're not looking fresh and clean. And now you're about to go in here and require a service from this doctor and you medical person, and you ain't anyway. I just thought I'd share that. So we are on our way to the P.O. box. We actually just checked the P.O. box. When was that? Tuesday when we were out. I don't even remember what we were out. Oh, we had a doctor's appointment. So yeah, that was Tuesday. Because not only did... See, I had a doctor's appointment, but I also had somebody with me who had a doctor's appointment. I had to take somebody for a doctor's appointment. So now we are going to check the P.O. box again. It's probably not anything in there, but I don't get out it that much. So while I'm here and in the vicinity, I might as well check it. So yeah, I'll bring you back when we get to, oh, and I did not mean to turn here. You guys, I'm just all over the place. I think that little pajama thing just really messed with my mind a little bit. Because I'm like, really? Anyway, I'll bring you guys back when we get to the post office. Okay, guys, we're leaving the post office. I didn't take you in with me because I was just trying to get in and out. And it wasn't anything to see, really. So, we are now headed to Office Depot. Yeah, Office Depot to print out this label for the return of this package for Amazon. And I don't know if I told you or not, but the curtains, the last set of curtains that I ordered, because I've ordered probably three different times, this last order came in yesterday at the same time as the new selfie stick came in, and they are like almost perfect. Like, they're perfect for the blackout part, which was what issue I kept running into with the other sets that I ordered. They're like a gold color, and you'll get to see them. I just love the pattern. The only thing that is messing with me a little bit about it is, although it matches my comforter set that I have on my bed now, I feel like I'm gonna need to order another set of blackout curtains, because my other comforter set that you all have seen, you've seen the one, and then there's another one that you haven't seen, at least I don't think you have. It's more of like a gray and pink tones to it, and these curtains are gold. So I'm thinking I'm gonna need to order another set of curtains that will match my other bed linens when I put them on, so that I can kind of just switch them out. It's what I'm thinking I'm gonna need to do, because the gold is kind of messing with me, because my bedroom furniture is silver. So I don't know, we'll see. I'm almost positive though, because it kind of messes with me just a little bit right now that my bedroom furniture is silver but my bedding is gold. And it's probably just me. I just need to get used to it. But they are so pretty, and the pattern and everything, and the blackout portion of it, everything is perfect in that regard. It's just that I'm kind of like, should I have went with more of a gray or a silver so that it matched the bedroom furniture, and it would have went okay with the comforter I have on there now, and would have really went with my other bed linen. And I may be overthinking it, because it's probably not even that serious. I'm probably making it more than it needs to be, because everybody probably does not match their window treatments with their linens, bed linens. So anyway, once I'm going to have to record and show you all, because I've got the rug that I got down, it actually looks better than I thought it was going to look. And then I've got the ottoman with storage in place. It looks really good. So I will show you guys, probably not in this video. I don't know, because I feel like this video is going to already be like super long. So we'll see. But I'll bring you back when we get to Office Depot. Okay, guys, a change of plans. We're not going to end up going to Office Depot today, I don't think. Because I just remembered that I need to pick up my contact lenses. And I did go to Office Depot's parking lot, and it was pretty full. I don't know if people were there for the print center or what. But where I need to pick up my contact lenses is the complete opposite direction. And I'm just kind of feeling like I might be able to just print off the label myself, either by way of having somebody print it off for me or just going to Office Depot maybe this weekend to do it. But I really need to get my contact lenses, because if you remember, they close at noon on Fridays and they're not open on the weekends. And so I'm already out and had prepared to pick them up. So I'll go ahead and get those today. So I'm not sure if we're going to end up at Office Depot and the UPS store today or not. Because like I said, this vlog is already pretty long. Probably going to just go to the doctor's office, pick up the contact lenses, and grab something to eat. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I just don't know what that is going to be just yet. So I'll be back. Okay, guys, I picked up my contact lenses, and I checked my phone, because you guys know I use my phone to record and how many issues I've had with it as far as storage goes. And I am pretty close to the storage being full, so I'm not even sure if I'm going to be able to use everything that I've recorded. So I'm going to go ahead and close the vlog out. The only thing I have left to do, like I said, today is I'm going to go pick up my prescriptions and grab something to eat and then go home and get logged on for work. So I think I'm going to close this out and pray that I can use what I've got so far with as footage is concerned. If this is your first time to the channel, welcome. I'm so glad to have you. So glad that you decided to stop in and check us out and see what we're doing. If it's not your first time, welcome back. How have you been? I ask that you click the like button. By clicking the like button, it lets YouTube know that you're enjoying the content on this channel. This always happens. This always happens. And it's gonna ring until, okay, I'll be back, guys. Okay, as I was saying, if you click the like button, it lets YouTube know that you're enjoying the content that's on this channel, and it will put our channel in front of other YouTube watchers who enjoy similar content. I ask that you click the subscribe button. We would love to have you join the family. So click the subscribe button and also click the bell. The bell will notify you anytime new content has been loaded to the channel. And finally, we're trying to grow our channel. So I ask that you share. Let those that you know that enjoy YouTube know that we have a great channel here and that we do a variety of different things and talk about a variety of different subjects, and that we would love to have them join us. So by sharing, it's going to allow us to grow our channel. We're trying to reach 100 subscribers, and we can do it. I'm counting on you, depending on you. I know you can get us there. And I want to grow our channel organically. I don't want to buy subscribers. I don't want to stray away from the core of what this channel is. I want to grow it organically. So before I get out of here, I do want to leave you with this. Remember, the plans for your life have already been designed. It's just up to you to trust the planner. Have a good one, everybody.